is the moment.
I don't want to talk shit about nobody, but that's something that really bothers me, and I have to come here and talk to you guys, express myself here. Having a guy like John Jones, the guy that has never lost a fight, he's a double champion. His last fight, he make it look very easy when he finished Ciryl Gane. This guy is second place on pound for pound ranking. And we have the number one place, Islam Makhachev, which has only two title defenses. His title defense was against a 145er. Volkanov is a great fighter, but he's a 145er. That's not gonna change. That's his vision. And having Islam Makhachev on first spot on the pound for pound ranking, it make no sense to me. Whoever does their rankings, whoever is responsible for that, I can't take it seriously. It make no sense at all.
UFC 300该如何让观众满意？昨天 UFC 总裁 Dana White 又宣布了两场对战，让这场历史性的数字战更具可看性。其中包括了 Justin Gaethje 将要防卫 BNF 腰带对上 Max Holloway。如果 Gaethje 获胜，他将成为第一位 BNF 卫冕冠军。Max Holloway 之前也曾身上轻量级，跟钻石 Dustin Poirier 打零次冠军战，可惜最后输掉。老板宣布的另一场对决是上周末出战拿下降服胜的老将 Jim Miller， 终于如愿以偿卡进 UFC 300，对手是 Bobby Green。Jim Miller 也将是唯一一个参加 UFC 100、200、300胜位的选手。根据网站数据 ，BNF 冠军赛的开盘赔率，海奈稍微被看好能打赢天佑成为热门。我觉得之后给几会拉大差距，不知道你各位怎么想的呢？而再加上 BNF 之后，目前 UFC 300已经有了两场冠军战。大家都知道 BNF 腰带的娱乐性质偏高，即使是 Highlight 跟天佑也很难成为历史大战的主赛。预计 UFC 还得再端出其他大战来满足拳迷。那么你各位心中有没有可能的对战组合呢？Francis Ngannou 跟 Anthony Joshua 刚完成了第一场新闻发布会，在发布会上，当地拳赛顾问说，打赢这场拳赛的人有望跟2月17号 Tyson Fury 和 Alexander Usyk 之间的胜者对决，到时候多个重量级拳王头衔都会被放上台面。
In the fight, you're trying to hit somebody in the chin or wherever you can hit him. Yes, I heard that he does have a chin. I don't know if it's true or not. I hope I had an opportunity to test that out.That's my wish.
另外，当晚的 co-main event 将是 WBO 临时冠军张志磊对上上个月打赢青铜轰炸机的 Joseph Parker， 这也是张志磊一直期待的对决。虽然可以写说自己还没放弃综合格斗，但他在拳坛这么热门，要看他重返 MMA 战场还得要等等了。UFC 原定在今年3月2号举办在沙烏地阿拉伯的首场赛事，但根据 The MMA Hour 指出，这场赛事要延到6月了。原因是阿拉伯金主们认为当晚比赛心度不够。目前已定的8场比赛中，只有3个排名内的选手。The MMA Hour 还说，本来这场赛事只是免费的 Fight Night Card， 现在有可能会转成 Pay Per View 形式。在这种情况下，日前提出希望在6月打卫冕战的 Islam Makhachev 是最有可能的选择。现在有希望成为下一个轻量级挑战者的人选，都被插入4月的 UFC 300大战了。假如当中有人能在 UFC 300完败对手全身而退，也许有机会赶上在6月底跟小小鹰打冠军战。Magomed Ankalaev 在上周末 KO Johnny Walker 之后，积极的想挑战冠军。在 Jamal Hill 还不确定何时回归的情况下，巨鹰希望能插队跟 Alex Pereira 打冠军战。他在 X 发文标注 Pereira 说，他可以答应不用摔跤，只用 Pereira 擅长的踢拳来跟他打，还说自己打得比 Adesanya 更重。但不久后 ，Alex Pereira 发了影片配文，影片出自谢师傅 Glover Teixeira 被 Jamal Hill 打败时的画面，看起来怨念很深啊。他说自己现在的目标是 Jamal Hill， 但同时也说 Ankalaev 不用等太久，因为他的计划是打破用最短的时间卫冕两次的记录。目前最短卫冕记录保持人是 Ronda Rousey， 女王。之前在 UFC 168跟170分别打败 Misha Tate 跟 Sarah McMahon， 两次只相差了56天。在 Pereira 最新的自拍影片中，他说他的下个对手已经安排好了，但现在还是个不能说的秘密。
我收到了经纪人的讯息，他告诉我我的下一场比赛都已经安排好了，在哪里跟谁打，很遗憾我不能告诉你各位，但很快你们就会知道了。
去年在 UFC 295上争冠失利的怪鸟 Jiri Frasca 日前在节目上透露，他的左腿赛前被葡萄球菌感染，在比赛的前五周内只能训练一周，但怪鸟从未考虑过退赛。
From the last five weeks of preparation, I trained just one week because the staph infection on my leg, then it started to travel in my body, like to my ear. One morning, I woke up and my ear was like 4 times bigger. Doesn't matter, I'm a warrior.And I'm going to fight, and I'm going to win every fight because I was many times in a fight like with the sick, with many injuries. I believe I can win. When you believe you can win, the way is open.
吉利普拉斯卡虽然神勇，但他的决定也受到很多责难。很多拳迷认为他不应该带着有接触传染风险的病出战，这对他的对手不负责任。贵人目前的下一场比赛是在 UFC 300对上 Alexander Rakic， 开盘普拉斯卡意外的以些微差距成为下狗。那么你各位认为怪鸟对上 Rakic 谁的赢面高呢？Conor McGregor 跟 Michael Chandler 的对决预计在6月开打，体重定在中量级。上周 Chandler 在自己的 YouTube 频道上评价了嘴炮的力量，并公开征求他的举重影片。
He is not stronger than me. So I don't need to gain weight. I don't need to gain any more strength. I don't need to do any more than what I'm already doing. I would like anybody in the comments, I would like anybody to tag me in videos of him lifting heavy weights. I actually looked before I actually got on this video. You can't find any videos of this man lifting heavy, heavy weights. Now,
正如为你预期的，前师傅马上收到嘴炮的回应。Dominic Cruz 最近在播客节目上承认，在职业生涯中从来不会刻意的去帮忙促销比赛。他接着分享了数年前跟正在崛起的 Conor McGregor 对话。现在的他感到有点后悔，没有听从 Conor 这个后辈的建议。
I'll take you back to one story in particular. I had just beat Takaya Mizugaki in a minute after a long layoff that everybody. I get done and I win and I come up to the top and I'm sitting next to Conor. He's got his pearl white suit on and his hair up with a Viking look going on at that time. He shakes my hand and he goes, "Very nice fight. You're a legend, OG in the sport, whatever." Like very kind. And he goes, "Man, you should go up there and grab those belts. Just stand up with them right on your shoulders and just tell everybody that you're here and that you're the champion." And I remember looking at him thinking, well, he's really good. He's going to rise right up. And this is what up-and-comers look like. But, you know, I'm just going to keep quiet. I'm going to sit here and I'm going to do my job. And I'm going to be respectable and humble because I don't know what comes next. That's not marketing. You know, marketing is do it. Apologize later if you need to. I just, I went the respectful, and that's the difference in marketing versus not. It's do you get up there and...Well, I believed in myself. I also wanted, I just had a different direction in my mind. Whereas Conor would grab that up, went up there, grabbed the belt, threw him over his shoulder, and, you know, did the whole march.
2023年拿下零胜两败的 Benil Dariush 日前在访谈中被要求预测 Charles Oliveira 跟 Armen Zarukian 对决，大刘是认为比赛时间可能是关键。
Honestly, I think that's a good fight. I think Armen has a strength and speed advantage, but experiences with Charles, so it just how far in the fight goes and how the fight goes is hard to say. I think early I would go with Armen, but if we go deeper into the fight, I would go with Charles. He seems to come alive as the fight goes. Great fighters seem to find holes as the fight gets longer.I think he can pull that off. But at the same time, Armen can finish it early on, or he could ride him out because he's got all the skills.
今年第一场 Pay-Per-View UFC 297将在本周末开打，你各位对比赛卡斯还满意吗？如果期待值不高， Bet Online 网站现在针对主赛 Sean Strickland 对上 Dricus Duplessis 开放了一些特殊玩法来增加比赛乐趣，项目还包括了赛前的记者会嘴炮战，一起来瞧瞧。昨天 Sean Strickland 在自己的博客中警告 DDP 不要再提到他的童年创伤。
I actually sent him a message and I was like, dude, listen, Dragus, we're gonna go try to murder each other, but if you bring that shit up again, I will stab you.
UFC 297赛前记者会预计会在这星期四登场，但昨天 UFC 释出的影片显示，两人稍早在饭店巧遇的过程十分友好，也许记者会会比证件发表会还要和平。女子草量级的 Poliana Viana 将在本周末的 UFC 297跟 Jillian Robertson 交手。Poliana 是忠实火影粉，除了胸前的佩恩，最近又新增了一些亮点。看起来青春靓丽的 Poliana Viana 现在31岁，她已经有一个14岁的儿子了。Poliana 说儿子是她职业生涯的动力，但是最近几场战绩不稳定，去年一直出赛一场，但第二回合被降服。冲着她的高颜值和跟我相同的还好，希望这位辣妈周末有好的表现，可以持续在八角笼亮相。你各位也是这么想的，对吧？